Thank you, ma'am. One more way of preventing pneumonia is by immunizing the children against the organism causing it. So now I would like to call upon stage Dr. Aliza Mittal, assistant professor in the Department of Pediatrics, to talk about immunization in pneumonia.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. So we come to the last talk of the day, and I know I'm standing between you people and the lunch, but mind you, I'm sure I'm not going to take more than 10 minutes. And it's a very important topic, and for most of you, it's just going to be a revision of what we already know about immunization in pneumonia. So we already have heard throughout the day that pneumonia is a cause of around 156. We have almost 156 million new cases of pneumonia every year, and it causes around 2 million deaths in children in less than 5 years of age. And India alone accounts for around 20% of global deaths due to pneumonia in this age group. However, vaccination reduces this risk. It does not eliminate the risk of pneumonia. So while there is risk reduction, it accounts for almost half of the world pneumonia cases which can be reduced by vaccination. So we all know that we have three vaccines which can prevent pneumonia of various causes. That is the conjugated and the polysaccharide vaccines against the pneumococcus, the H influenza B vaccine, and the seasonal influenza vaccine. So let's quickly look at all of these. So the HIP vaccine, we all know we are using these vaccines day in and out for immunizing our children. And the minimum age at which we start is at 6 weeks, and it's a part of the government program, so the patient does not have to pay for it. And we give it at 6, 10, and 14 weeks, along with a booster at 12 months. The catch-up is recommended only till 5 years of age, so you need not worry about children who are older than that. For children who come to us at less than 12 months, but they have not received the vaccination as part of the primary schedule, you can give them 2 doses. And after that, a single dose along with a booster would be sufficient. So above 5 months of age, you need not give the booster also. Only a single dose of the vaccine for HIP would be sufficient. So coming to the pneumococcal vaccines, so we all know that there are conjugated vaccines and there are the polysaccharide vaccines. Polysaccharide vaccines have to be given after 2 years of age because of the changes in the immunity and the T cell and the memory cells that take place. So PCV10 is the Synflorix vaccine. We all know that, which is available in the market. And then it has a cousin, which is much more expensive, which is PCV13, covers for 3 additional serotypes. The cost between the two is almost double, but the benefit as to which one is better is still not clear. There are studies which are going on, but as of now, they say that either of the two vaccines can be used and none of the two is better. However, PCV13 covers for 3 additional vaccines, whereas PCV10 has, and there is a variant available which will also cover for H influenza B. However, since we already have H influenza B as a part of our national program, we can use the plain Synflorix. So we can give it starting at 6 weeks of age up to 5 years. And I've already stated about the cost of Prevnar, which is prohibitive in most of the cases. However, PCV13 can also be given to adults who are more than 50 years of age. So the primary schedule is the 3 doses of vaccines at 6, 10, and 14 weeks, along with a booster at 12 months up to 15 months. And for catch-up in children up to 1 year of age, you can use 2 doses. From 1 to 2 years of age, that is 12 to 23 months, we again use 2 doses, but the duration has to be 8 weeks apart rather than 4 weeks apart, like we do in children less than 1 year of age. And above 24 months, we give a single dose. Now, we are all aware that the Government of India has last year launched this program where the vaccine has now been introduced as a part of the national program. Starting from the state of Himachal Pradesh, Bihar, and Uttar Pradesh, they say that this year it's going to be introduced in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh, and in a phased manner in the rest parts of our country. So these are the high-risk conditions which warrant the use of pneumococcal vaccine, which includes chronic heart and lung disease, diabetes, CSF leaks, and cochlear implants, children and adults with anatomical and functional asplenia, and other immunocompromising conditions like transplant, malignancies, immunosuppressive drugs, HIV infection, renal failure, and nephrotic syndrome. Now, when we talk about vaccinating these persons with high-risk conditions with pneumococcal vaccine, we talk about children and adults who are above 2 years of age. So From 2 to 5 years of age, we can give a single dose of PCV13. And if that patient has already received the 3 doses of PCV previously, we can just give them 2 doses, at least 8 weeks apart. And after 6 years of age, a single dose of PCV13 to be given. However, it should be borne in mind that we should not give PPSV or the polysaccharide vaccine directly. That is, it should be given only after we have vaccinated the child with PCV13 or PCV10, and then we go over to giving the polysaccharide vaccine. And this polysaccharide vaccine should be given at least 8 weeks after the last dose. So the minimum age at which we can give the polysaccharide vaccine is 2 years, and it is not recommended for routine use. We need to give it only to patients who have the high-risk conditions or other conditions. So all the younger babies who are receiving the PCV13 vaccine, they need not be given the pneumovax or the polysaccharide vaccine. So we can give them an additional dose after 5 years if they have received a polysaccharide vaccine in the age group of 2 to 5 years. So lastly, coming to the influenza vaccine, the minimum age at which we start vaccinating the child with influenza vaccine is 6 months. So now there are two variants, the inactivated and the live attenuated vaccine. VaxiFlu 4 is the newer variant, which is going to be launched very soon by Abbott, and it's going to cover for four different strains of the influenza virus. VaxiGrip is the older one, which was in use till very recently, and Influvac is another one which they are using. The live attenuated vaccine known as Nasovac is also available. However, it should not be used in children less than 2 years of age. So for most healthy children aged 2 to 18 years, we can use either of the two vaccines. But for younger children, it's better to use the inactivated vaccine. So how to decide upon revaccination with newer types of vaccines in influenza which are coming up every year? So can anybody give an answer to that? Okay, so as per the IAP recommendation, a child who has received 2 doses of the vaccine any time in the future, it may not have been in a single year or it may not have been in 2 consecutive years, anybody who has received 2 doses of vaccine, we can give them a single dose of the newer strain of vaccine. And somebody who has received only a single dose previously should receive 2 doses of the newer strain or the new formulation which is now available. Now, these two new doses need not have been received during the same season or consecutive seasons. Now, for children who are older than 6 months up to 8 years, we give them 2 doses separated by at least 4 weeks whenever they are receiving the vaccine for the first time. Now, irrespective of whether a previous vaccine has been given or not. All the currently available influenza vaccines in the country, they do contain the strain which covers for swine flu. So there's no need to vaccinate them separately. And for those who have chronic medical conditions, live attenuated vaccines are contraindicated. We already know that. So the best time to vaccinate is as soon as the new vaccine is released and just before the onset of rainy season, or we can also give it just prior to the onset of winters based on the local epidemiology data. These are the contraindications for live attenuated vaccine. I'm sure all of you are known, are well aware of these, and they are also the ones which are given by the IAP guidebook on immunization. So severe allergic reactions to live attenuated vaccine, aspirin or aspirin containing products, immunodeficiency, children through 2 to 4 years of age with asthma, or children who have taken influenza antiviral medications in the previous 48 hours should not receive live attenuated influenza virus vaccine. We have various opportunities to immunize the children, at least 4 opportunities in the first year of life. And since we know that it can cause up to 50% reduction in the incidence of pneumonia, we must make an effort to vaccinate our children against influenza and against pneumonia. And these are the other major causes of pneumonia we are well aware of. However, these are not preventable by vaccination at the moment. So I would end my talk here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Dr. Kuldeep Singh for certificate distribution.